Hi everyone, it's Donovan at Spaceman Paper Crafts, and I am back with another design team video today for Genevieve Designs. I'm gonna focus on the small keepsake album today. I have already made the box from the kit. So this is my box, and I've used the Gorgeous Girls by Santoro range to embellish. And I've popped a little tag inside this pocket and I just stamped a little sentiment on there. Just in case you're wondering, that comes from a May May Made It set, which is called Sunflower Wishes. So that's where that's from. So I just punched a hole, put a brad and put some twine in there, and then I just laid some black lace down and used these resin flowers and a couple of keys. I really like keys on projects lately, I don't know why. The box closure, I used a magnet, but I put one of these resin flowers on as well, and then I just popped a little picture on the inside. Okay, so, oh, and I've got some little gems on the feet. So I'm going to walk you through what you need to print out to create the box. The box is very simple to make, as are all of the kits that you can buy from Jennifer's Etsy store. Everything comes with a guide and tells you what you need to print out and what you need to draw around, things like that. It's all very, very self-explanatory, and every time there is a new item out in the Etsy store, Jennifer will do a tutorial. So if you look on Jennifer's YouTube channel, I'll leave the link for that in the description bar, as well as the link for her Etsy shop. Also, you will see tutorials of all of the albums and boxes, etc., that Jennifer has in her Etsy store. So I'm just trying to cover this up because I don't want the glare of the light to annoy you. So this is how I've stored mine. So I've showed you the box. So to make the box, you would need to print out all four pages. Okay. This is the box template that you would cut out, score, and draw around on your chipboard for your box. Then page two is the finishing strips. Now Jennifer's put two on each page, but you only need one set, so there's, going to be a spare set, so you'd need to print those off. And page three, you have your inside mat templates. Now, if you wanted to print these directly onto pattern paper, you can certainly do that and then cut them out. That's fine. If you wanted to use like a 6x6 or an 8x8 pad that might not necessarily go through your printer, then you can print them out like I have onto some cardstock, and they become templates then that you can draw around on your paper. So these are the inside mats, which are on page three, and also the closures are here as well. You can use any one of those closures or one of your own. So then page four, same principle again, but these are the outside mats. So if you wanted to print yours directly onto pattern paper, I have here because I wanted to utilize the text background that Jennifer sent me with my kit this month. So I love that text background. As soon as I saw it, I fell in love with it. I think it's great. So these would be the outside mats. So again, same principle applies. You would just cut them out from your papers if you wanted to use them as templates, or you would print them directly onto your patterned papers. Okay, so that's the box, and it's really, really easy to assemble. I'll leave the link for Jennifer's video showing you how to assemble the keepsake box. Okay, for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to do the album with you. It's kind of like an album box. Well, I actually want to turn mine into a little photo album. My sister recently got married, and we have an aunt that was quite poorly and couldn't make it. So I am going to decorate it with you, but before I give it to her, I'm going to pop some photographs of the wedding in there so she can see those. Okay, so on page one, you're going to print this out onto your cardstock. So this is the part one of the cover. Okay, and this is your binding. So you need to print both of those out and trim those. And then the next page, page two, is actually part two of the cover and your divider sections. Now, if I bring over my mock-up here, you can see that these dividers will form your pockets, and this is how your album will come together. Okay, so your four dividers. Then on page three, these are your inserts. Okay, and if I show you again with the one that I've already made, they sit in like so you can open them up, and that's what I'm going to use as my photo mats when I send mine to my aunt. So you're only going to need four of these. Is it four or five? I can't remember. Is it four or five? One, two, three, four, five. I was right. I was going to say I cut five out. I did. Okay, so you're going to need five of those all cut out. There is going to be one spare because you need to print this page out twice to get the right amount of to get five inserts. So you're going to have one spare. So I'll just leave that in your book so it's there and ready. Then on page four, these are the mats for the covers and the inserts. Okay, now I've printed mine out. Well, I wanted to do a mixture, some with the text background and some without. So I've just taken some papers from random different paper packs that I really like, and I've just printed that page off with the text background onto a few different patterned papers. Seem to have a lot of blue. I've got some pink here as well somewhere. Yep. So I've printed them off because I'm not too sure what colours I want to do. I know I want to tie in with the blue and the cover. But I'm going to, when it comes time to do the mats, I'm going to keep the spares pieces that I took off from the 12 by 12s to run through my printer, and I'm going to do some plain ones as well. So for the moment, I'm just going to leave those in there, and that is all you need. So I'll move my book up to the side. Okay, first thing I want to do is to make the album base itself. So I'm going to bring in my scoreboard, and I'll just use my Martha Stewart scoring tool, and you're going to line up the score lines. All these are score lines, and you're going to line those up and just score them. Line them up and just score those, and then you're going to take part two of the cover, which is on page two, and you're going to score that along that score line as well. Oops, I've just jumped that. There we go. So we're just going to fold and burnish these score lines. Of all the kits, all the album kits I've tried, this is probably the quickest one to put together, in my opinion. You could probably get this put together, including the box, depending on how quick you work, obviously, but maybe an hour or two. Okay, so that's going to be stuck to there, and that's going to be the outside of our little box album. Okay, so before I do that, I'm going to do some inking. Now, on my box, I used Distress Stain, but I used Faded Jeans. I normally use Vintage Photo and everything, but I fancied a bit of a change today, and I was really inspired by this picture and this little pocket. So I went with Faded Jeans for the outside of the box, and then for all the outside of the album and the dividers, etc., all the paper, it's going to be Faded Jeans distress ink. So I'm just going to distress these edges, ink them all up. I've never tried using a different colour. I've always used like Vintage Photo, like I said, or Walnut Stain or tea dye, but I've never thought of going for one of the blues, and I actually really really like how this turns out. It's really really nice, still gives it that vintage look, but yeah, the colour, a little bit of colour is nice. So I'll just do part two of the cover. Lines. Okay, so now we're going to put our cover together. So we're going to put some score tape on this flap on the first part of the on part one of the cover. I'm just going to put it up to the score line and trim it. And then I put another piece down here, and then I put some wet glue on there as well. If you had half inch score tape, it might be better, but I don't. I only have quarter inch. Trim that a little bit off there. I do have to apologise, guys, for my nails. I get so annoyed with myself because my sister has a salon and they do hair and nails and beauty treatments and things, and I just don't ever seem to get a chance to utilise it. It's really annoying. Okay, so there's some wet glue there. I'm just using some art glitter glue. I find this really really good. It dries really quick, but it does still give you that little bit of wiggle room. So I'm going to zoom you in and show you where I'm going to pop this. It's just going to go to the score line. Okay, and press that down. I'm just going to run over that with my foam folder as well. If any of your wet glue, if you're using this glue, seeps out, don't worry, it dries clear anyway. Okay, so far that is the base of our album cover. Okay, and now we're going to work on the concertina sides, which are these bits here. Okay, so for that you're going to need the second part of page one that we cut out, and these lines are all score lines, so we're going to score every one of these lines apart from this one in the middle. You can see which is the middle one because it's got those little points that you need to snip off. So we're going to line these up. Now if you're making your own concertina, these are half inch increments, but as they're printed out like this, as Jennifer would say, and it's true, every printer prints differently. So what might be half an inch for somebody else might not be for you. So if you're doing your own, you would score at half an inch, every half an inch, but with this one because the score lines are put in for you, you just line your score line up top and bottom and score. And it may, the next one may not be, see that one's just not quite half an inch. So I'm just going to move it until we can line it up and score. And we're going to do that with the whole panel. Okay, so that's all our piece scored. Now we need to cut it down the middle, so I'm just going to get my paper trimmer back in. And I'm just going to trim this down the middle. To give us our two sides. And then if you look closely on the side, you've got some little edges that you need to snip off. And this will help with lining up the corners, the edges on your binding. So we're going to do that on all four corners. Okay, let's get these bits out of the way. Okay, you're going to need your bone folder now, and the end bit, the first bit, will fold towards you, okay? So it will fold over towards you, so that first fold is a mountain, then the next one is a valley, and you want to score these, or burnish these, as you do them. So again, mountain and valley. Do you ever do these at school? I always remember doing these at school when I wanted to make a fan. When I was younger, I would concertina up pieces of paper and create little fans. So mountain, valley. And then the last one there. Okay. So that's what it should look like. Okay, and I'm just going to do exactly the same with this one. Okay, we're just going to ink these up now. I'm not going to add any ink from the ink pad, I'm just going to use what's left on the tool. That one inked, and we'll do exactly the same with this one. Okay, I've just popped some score tape on the end, on two of the end pieces. Doesn't matter which ends that you use, and then we're going to bring back in our cover, and these bits are going to stick down to our cover like that. Okay, so I'm going to take the first bit off and I'm going to line it up. And I'm just going to give that a little burnish. And then I'm going to do exactly the same thing on this side. So in the end, you have something that looks like this. Okay, so remember that your first piece goes down so that the outer edges that you've inked are on the underneath of here. Okay, so then what you need to do is you need to skip this first section where we've just stuck it down and put tape or wet glue on the next bit. And then we're just going to start folding in our dividers. Okay, so get our score tape again. So again, we miss this one and we pop it on here. Miss the next one and pop that there. Again, miss this one. Miss the next one and put it here. Then the last one I believe we put on there, but I'm not going to put that on just till we make sure. So miss one and then pop a piece there. I'm just tearing the tape for quickness. Miss one. Some tape there, miss one and add tape. So now you need to bring in your four divider pieces that were on page two. Okay, and then I'm just going to ink up the top of these because it's only going to be the top. I just want to make sure that they are, I think, yeah, they're a little bit too wide. Are they all going to be the same? Yes. So I'm just going to bring in my trimmer and just trim a fraction off each of the sides because the length is fine, I believe. Let me just double check. Yeah, that's fine. It's just a little bit of on the width. And then I think this is the last one. Yep. Okay. So, now I'm just going to ink up what's going to be the top of each one. Again, with the faded jeans. Just at the top and a bit of the side. So now you will end up with something that looks a bit like that. And then we're going to turn it into something that looks like that. So you're going to take your first divider, put the inked side face down, okay, and you're going to line that up with the top section here. Okay, doesn't matter if it's short there because you're not going to see the bottom, but you must remember to make sure that it's level with the top. And then I'm just going to peel off the double-sided tape. You can do one at a time if you want to. Stick that down and then stick that down there. And that's given us our first little pocket for our insert. Okay, so we're going to repeat this. So again, inked side facing downwards. Make sure we're lined up at the top. Peel off the backer. I'll just do one at a time this time. And then peel off this side. And then fold that over. So now we've got two little pockets. Okay, so again, inked side facing downwards, line it up with the top, and fold that piece over, and then the next one. So that gives us three pockets. Now the last divider is going to go in here. And remember, inked side facing downwards again. Line it up with the top. And then fold this one over. And then exactly the same thing with this side. Okay. And then the last one, so that's the fourth. The fifth one is created when we close up our little album. So I'm going to pop some tape, score tape, on this piece, and then I'm going to add some wet glue as well. And then a bit of score tape on this side. So I'm going to peel the backers off. And then just pop some wet glue on there as well. And then do exactly the same on this side. Okay, now it is going to be a little bit fiddly to get it lined up, but let's give it a go. I'm going to temporarily press because I know that's not right. It's a good thing putting this little bit of wet glue on. Gives us a minute or two. It will get there, you'll just, if it gets a little bit fiddly, just persevere with it and it will get to the right place. Once you've got the first one in place, the second one's much easier. Okay, so I'm just going to pop my bone folder down in there, in that crease. Make sure that's stuck down really well. And again on this side. So let's get all these bits out of the way and we can see what we've got so far. Put the ink, the pin back in my glue before that dries out. So there we go, we've got the, oh, that's not quite stuck down yet. More burnish down. There we go, that's better. So, and there we have our little box album. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is the inserts. So I've cut all these out. So there's five there. And again, we're just going to score along the score lines that are made for you. Okay, so you just line it up and score, and that's one of your inserts. Okay, so we're going to do the same with all five of them. and then the last one, and then I'm just going to ink those all up and then I'll be right back. Okay, we're back and I have inked up all five of these, back and front, and I've picked the paper that I'd like on my cover. Although I do want it a bit more blue, I want it a bit more of that colour, so I'm just going to take my faded jeans, and I've just got a wipe clean, like it's a heat resistant mat, and I'm just going to start on the mat and I'm just going to bring it in and just gently go over the whole sheet. So just to ink this bit up now, I'm going to have to re-ink again when I trim these out. It's better to ink them all. If you're changing the colour of everything, it's better to do it while they're all connected on one piece. And then that way you can just ink up the edges then when you're done. And now we're going to attach our cover like that. Okay, I'm just going to use wet glue. Again, it's just going to be the art glitter glue. Whoops. A precision tip on this as well, which makes it quite a lot easier as well. And then just work your way around. You obviously don't have to have the whole cover in the same paper. You can have different colours. I just wanted to keep within the blue theme for my covers. And now before I put the next bit on at the front, I want to do my magnetic closure. Okay, so I'm going to take my magnets. Which size I use, that was that size. Okay, and then I'm going to get a little bit of score tape, because score tape really works on this. So I need to just pop some score tape on the inside there. Then I'll cover it up with the inside patterned paper. And then stick that down. And then I'm just going to click those two magnets together, pop another piece of score tape on there, and then I want to make sure it's lined up nicely. And then press that down. So I'm going to ease these off. Just press that down. so that's the magnetic closure done. So now I can stick this piece over and cover the magnet. And then I'll pop a little flower on, the same that matches the box where that magnet is. Whoops. So I'm just going to pop my bone folder in there. And stick that bit down really well on top of that magnet. Like so. Okay, now we're going to do the inside. Okay, so for the inside, I'm not going to have the text pattern. Okay, so I'm going to take out my templates, pop the lid in my glue. So I'm just going to take out the templates. Where are they? On page 4. I'll take all those out anyway. Won't need them all. So I've labelled all these. So that piece I need, and this piece I need. Okay, so I'm just going to find the piece of paper that I want to use. I might use the pink on the inside, I think. So I'm just going to line the template up. I'm going to take my pencil and draw around that. And then I'm going to draw around the second part that I need. And then I'm going to trim those out, ink them up, and then again, I'll be right back. Okay, so I've trimmed out these two pieces and inked them. And now I'm just going to stick them onto the inside of my album covers. Is actually a little bit long, so I'm just going to, before that dries, take some scissors and just trim the bottom. Stuck down around that magnet. And then I'll pop this little piece in. I think I know why these mats are going to be slightly too big. I printed out the all the mats and things on a different printer because I've changed my printer over, so I think that's why my settings are slightly different. So these might be a little bit long. So that's the front cover done. I think it looks really cute. And now we're going to work on the inserts. Okay, so I'm going to bring in the inserts that I've printed onto the patterned paper. So I'm going to cut all these out. I'm going to cut these four out, and there should be a fifth from, yes there is. So I'm going to cut all these out, and then I'm going to ink them, and then I'm going to come back, and then I will do the tracing out of the templates again with you, and you can see, just get another idea of how that's done. Okay guys, I won't be long. Okay guys, I'm back, and I have cut out and inked all the printed pieces. Now remember, I printed the text background on these. How many have I got there? Should I have five? Yep. And these are the bottom bits for the inserts. These are the ones that I've cut out myself. I've got four of each, so I'm going to do another one with you. So I'm just going to turn this over, and then I'm going to take the insert mat for the top and the insert mat for the bottom, and I'm going to trace around them. Okay, so that's them inked, and then what will happen is on the inside, let me just take one of the inserts, they'll just be stuck on and mounted as such. And I've cut myself a photo mat. Now this is probably about 2/8, maybe 2/8 of an inch smaller than the mat piece. Okay, I can't give you what the exact measurements are because everyone's printer is going to print slightly different, but I've cut myself out this mat. Now what I've done is I went to my printer and I printed out some photographs and cut them all down to that size, so I know that they're going to be able to sit comfortably on my inserts. And these are pictures of my sister's wedding, a new husband. That's all my sisters, my mum, and all our children. That's a lot of, isn't there? what else can I show you? That's my sister and my son. That's my little boy. That's Riley. Well, I say little boy, he's 12, and he's yeah, he's quite tall. My sister in her shoes was 5'5", so he's a fraction taller than her, and again he's only 12. So, and then my sister and my mum, and then my sister and my new brother-in-law. So there should be some more actually. Yeah, my sisters too, my niece and nephew. I think that's, yeah, that's it. So these are the pictures that I want to include in. But what I want to do, when I finish the album, I want to make a photo frame. Now I'm going to make a photo frame that's going to use the inside lid mat for the box. Okay, so we'll get to that in a second. I'll show you how to make a photo frame to match. So I'm going to get sticking all these bits and pieces in here. Again, the plain ones are going to be for the inside, and the text ones are going to go on the outside. So I'm just going to quickly put those in, and then I'll come back to you before I put the photos in. Okay, so we've got all our mats stuck on, the text versions for the outside and the plain on the inside. So now we're going to go and stick our photos in. Okay, just lean over and lay these out and see what order I want to put them in. So that's one of them at the actual ceremony. So prior to the ceremony, these were taken. So I'm going to put those in, and they just should fit nicely there. I haven't done them too tall because I don't need to see over this bit here. Okay. So I'm just going to stick these down with some glue. I printed these onto some Kodak photo paper. And then I'm just going to stick those that down there. Finish sticking all those down, and I'm just going to decide what order they're going to go in our album. So the first one should be the photos prior to the wedding, which are these ones. Then we'll try and run them in an order. Those, then this one, this one, and then the final one. So that's our little photo album, the construction done. I'm going to decorate the cover as well. I'm going to, I've got my hot glue gun heating up. I've got some, my little tray here. This was the, where I got all the flowers. These are the rose charms. So I'm just going to bring the box in and just have a little look at how I'm going to do the cover to tie in. Okay, oops. I have another one of these, but it's going to be too big. I do have some smaller ones. Again, they're going to be too big, aren't they? Okay, so we can't do that. So that's the cover now decorated as well. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is show you how to make a photo frame. So I'm just going to turn my hot glue gun off. Okay, so let's pop the box and the album to one side. Now, the inside lid mats from your box, which are on page 3 of the small keepsake box and album templates. So this is page 3, and this is the top part of page 3. Oops, I keep knocking my tripod. Okay, so page 3 of the box looks like this, and this is the inside lid piece. Okay, so that's the bit that we're going to need, and then you're going to get yourself some chipboard. I've got some mount board here. It's similar to chipboard, but this actually will go through my paper trimmer, but it's still quite sturdy. So what you need to do is you need to trace out two of these. I'll do it on the white side because I can see what I'm doing then. So we just need our pencil again, and we're just going to trace out two. So you need one for the cover, and then you need one for the back. I don't think I'm going to get one out of there. So I'll just draw around your template twice, and then keep hold of your template for a minute, and then I'm going to bring in my paper trimmer, because as I say, I can get this mount board through my paper trimmer, which is brilliant. So let's line up the line there and cut. Okay, that's one. And then we're just going to cut the other one out. Oops. Okay, so we've got our two pieces. And now to get the inside of the frame. Okay, so I measured in 5/8 of an inch. So I'll do it here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I know where that is now, so I'll just put a little mark there. And do another one a little bit further up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's entirely up to you how much space you want to leave on either side. If you want to do 1/2 inch or 3/4 inch, that'll be fine. So on my trimmer, I have, if I zoom you in and show you, on my blade, in fact, I'll take my blade out and show you. This little line here tells me where the blade's cutting. So I know that when I come down to the line, I know that I've come down enough. And then again, up to the line. Then your inside should, if I've got it, pop out. If not, just take a craft knife and just go over the marks, because the indentation's already there. Your score blade should be okay to go through. And then just the last one. Oops, I've just gone a little bit off there, that's fine. It's going to be covered with paper anyway. So, that's the frame. So then we're going to, see our other piece is just going to sit on the back, and we're going to put a stand on the back and stand that up. So I'm going to get the paper I need, I'm going to print off the text background again, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've got my two pieces cut out, and then what we're going to do, I've trimmed them out, and I've just realised that I've actually printed these on the wrong printer. I don't remember if I said at the beginning, half of the printables I'd done on my upstairs printer and the other half on the downstairs one. So that's fine, because now we've got a nice little mat and we don't have to trim another one round. But if you kind of eyeball it so it's sort of central, then flip it over and just trace out the inside. Then we'll be able to cut that out. But first, what I want to do is to get the distress ink and make them a little bit more blue. So this piece is going to be on the cover. I think I like the black side showing. And then this piece will just cover the inside. So if there's no picture in it, you can see. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to stick my picture in. You don't have to. You can measure it correctly enough and it will just slide in and out and you can change your pictures. But for the purposes of this, I am going to be... I'm going to glue that. I'm going to be... I'm going to be sticking mine in. Just want to glue that so it sticks back up there. It'll be fine because it'll all be covered and nobody will see it. Right, so I'm just going to get my distress ink again in Faded Jeans and just work these two pieces and change the colour on them. Okay, so I've got my pieces cut out and I've inked them all up so they match in with the album. And I've just, what I did on this one, was just lay down the frame and just sort of made it central. Because as I cut it out, I remembered that I'd printed the inserts and things out on different printers, so my printer settings were slightly off, but this is fine. This saves us then cutting out a border. So you line that up and just sort of eyeball it till it's central, flip it over and draw the shape out there. That's going to give us our opening on this piece. So what I'm going to do is I'll just use my craft knife, get the metal edge, and just go from edge to edge. So now that should line up quite nicely on our frame. Okay, so what we'll do is stick that down and then I'm going to show you how I make it flush on the inside. So I'm just going to pop some wet glue on. And then just take our frame and stick our paper down. Okay, I'm going to just go inside this with the craft blade and just trim off the excess that might be there. You may not get any excess, of course, but I must have been slightly off with my cutting. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a file and just run that through, and that smooths all that out so it's not going to sort of lift up. See, if I was to pull that now, that would lift up. So once you file it all down to your chipboard or mount board, then it should be perfectly fine and not lift. Providing you've got enough glue on it, of course. And then we just go back in with the ink blender and just cover any bits that we have made when we filed. Okay, and there's the outer frame. Now we'll put that to one side and we're going to work on the back of the frame. So I'm going to have this as the outer back. So it's like that. So what I need to do is I need to find a piece of the chipboard and I'm going to cut it about an inch, maybe an inch wide. So let me just get my trimmer again. I'm just going to trim out a piece that's about an inch. And then, depending on... Oh, that's actually not a bad size. So this piece is 1 inch by 3 7/8. So that's a good size for there. Then about half an inch in, what you're going to do is lightly score. So about half an inch in on one side, you're just going to... maybe half an inch, 3/4 of an inch. You're just going to lightly run your blade through it. Because we don't want to cut it, we just want to score it so it's pliable. Like so. Okay. And then if you want to, you can ink that bit up. But nobody will see it because as it stands, it's going to stand like this. So we're going to attach it onto the back of our frame. And it's going to be our stand. Okay, so to do that I'm going to use some brads. Let's see, oh, I've got some little black ones here, I'll use those two I think, and then we're going to poke some holes. So we're going to line this up. I'll zoom you in a little bit. So we're going to line this up with the bottom of our piece and then try and eye, I mean you can measure obviously if you want to find the exact centre, but I tend to find that eyeballing it works. Let me just get my craft pick and then I'm going to make two holes. And I'm going to push it in so I can mark the chipboard underneath so I know where those two holes are. Okay, so with these ones I'm just going to push them through and make them a bit bigger for the brads to go in, and then I'm going to do exactly the same on this part of the chipboard or mount board, whatever you're using. Okay, so we're just going to pop our brads through. These are quite small, so but you don't need anything too big, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to tape this and then I'm going to cover it as well, so it will be well stuck down and it will be held really well. Okay, so you put them through that way and then just open them out. So this then will become your stand for your frame. Okay, so I'm just going to put some tape over that just to keep that down. This is just some masking tape, or it doesn't matter what tape you use, scotch tape, doesn't matter. Just stick it down a bit and then we're going to stick our other piece on there as well. Okay, just to cover it all up. And then just make sure it's well pressed down. So that in effect is what our frame is going to look like. So what we need now is some acetate. Now I've got some really thick weight acetate that is quite thick, and sometimes I find it a bit too thick to use on shaker cards, so I think I'll just use that. And I'm just going to trim a piece out, and that should fit on the back of our frame really well. So while I've got the cutting board out, or the cutting tool out, I'm going to trim out a photograph that I'm hoping will fit without too much to trim off. But I'm just going to print it out, and then we'll see if I have to trim any off. No, I think that'll be okay. Yeah, because I am going to stick it down, as I say, to the acetate before I stick down the frame. Okay, so we'll pop the acetate on, and I'm just going to use some wet glue for the acetate. I'm just going to pop some wet glue around the frame. The trouble is with acetate, it picks up everything, doesn't it? This wet glue does dry really quite quickly. See, it's hardly moving now, so. And then I need to stick the picture down, but I'm just going to do that with some Scotch tape. As I said, you can, if you want to, pop your picture in where you need it to be and stick it down like I'm doing, or you can take the base and stick it down on three sides and leave the top side open so you can reuse the photo frame. But for this, I'm going to stick it down because I know that when I give it to my aunt, she won't take it out the frame and she won't need the frame for anything. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this side at the bottom, because this did not cut very well, so I'm going to decorate that side so it doesn't look too bad. Okay, so picture wise, let's get this to how I think it should sit. Yeah, that looks really good there. So I'm going to just fold that over and just pop that on there so it doesn't move, and just take some Scotch tape and just stick it down. Let me just check again. Yep, that's great. And then we're just going to pop another couple of pieces on just to make sure it's nicely secured. I mean, when we put the base on, it's not going to go anywhere anyway, because I'm going to attach the base with score tape. Okay, so that's the front of our frame. So now we're going to do the back. So the piece that I put the stand on is obviously the back piece. So I'm just going to pop some score tape on all four sides of this front piece. And this will give it a really good, sturdy, firm hold. I just realised I've turned my hot glue gun off. I'm going to need it again, aren't I? Okay, so now we're going to attach it. So we're just going to peel off the score tape. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to stand it up like this. And try and ease them both together. And there we go. There's our picture frame. So I'm going to get all some bits out now to decorate it and hopefully tie it in with the box and the album. So, yeah, I think this has turned out quite well actually. So, we've got a photo frame, a photo album, and a cute little box, all made using the small keepsake box and mini album printable templates bundle by the lovely Jennifer from Genevieve Designs. So I will leave all the links that you need, the links for Jennifer's YouTube, her Etsy store, and I really hope you give these bundles a go because they are brilliant and they are so easy, and the effects that you get from them and the things that you can do with them are just amazing. So you don't just have to make boxes and albums, you can make photo frames. And it'd be really nice if you used the large, the medium, and the small, and did a set of three matching photo frames. That'd be really nice too. So thank you so much guys for watching. I've really thoroughly enjoyed this design team video project, and I will be back next month with another one for you. So thanks so much guys for watching, and do take care. Lots of love. Bye for now.